Hello and welcome everyone to my channel Skanda Prasad. This is a special video for all of you who have just entered 12th and are studying very hard for KCET 2020. That is a master plan of 10 tips so that you can crack KCET 2020 with a really, really good rank. Now, I've made up my mind to tell you, I prepared these 10 points which are so important for you to, if you literally follow each and every one of them, sincerely, honestly, and if you be sincere with yourself, no need to be sincere with your teachers or your parents or anything, just be sincere with yourself and follow these points properly and then with your full dedication and your full concentration, I am sure you can crack the CET exam very well. So let's begin with the first one. The first one is, in a day, after college or if you have a holiday, whatever it is, practice maximum number of questions in one day. That is how much ever possible. Since it is CET level, at least you should be able to do, let's say, 50 to 60 at minimum. Because the level is pretty easy as compared to other competitive exams which are out there. So, I'd like to say that practice as many questions in a day as possible of different varieties of all the subjects, physics, chemistry as well as mathematics. If you are writing biology too. This was my first point. The second one is, pick the correct current chapters which are being taught in your college or coaching, whatever it is, and do questions only on that for a limited number of time. That's what I'm telling. Like, do some extra as well as whatever they are teaching. What I mean to say is, after you finish a few questions of the current chapter which is going on in your college, pick up any other topic of first PU, that is 11th, and do questions on that too. That is, you have to manage both in one single day. Don't just do only 12th or only 11th. Manage your time for both of them. And last, otherwise you'll start telling that I didn't get time to do 11th syllabus, I didn't revise. All those things will come as, what you say, excuses. So don't give any excuse to anybody. Prepare from now itself, every day. Using the textbooks for dedicated to both 11th as well as 12th. That is, divide your time efficiently in a day. If you have tests of college and all, only on those days, keep a margin of, at least do it, but like study more of 12th only on those days, but keep 11th at a minimum only on those days, but otherwise you should balance out both. This was my second point. The third one is, see, CET exam is all about accuracy. So you have to improve accuracy each and every day. Each and every day, you should focus on being better than what you were yesterday. So that is what is my third point. Since accuracy as well as speed, both of these are the key to cracking CET exam. So both accuracy as well as speed has to be improved. Now, how will you do that? Practicing maximum number of questions in one single day. The other thing I want to tell you is accuracy and speed. Many people get confused between these two terms. Accuracy is how, speed is nothing but how fast you do the problem. The result is not yet decided. That is whether you have done the problem correct or you have done the problem wrong. That is different. How fast you do the problem is what is called as speed of your solving the questions. But accuracy is whether you get it right or not. Out of 100 questions, you are said to be less accurate if you just get like 30-40 correct. And you are said to be more accurate when you solve 80 to 90 questions correctly. So that is what is important. Accuracy is really important along with speed. You both go hand in hand. So both you have to manage. So this was my next point. The other thing is, read at least one chapter from NCERT every day. Just pick up NCERT book. Keep like at least like 1 or 1.5 hour. Just read one chapter, because NCERT is the key to cracking CET exam. Many things are asked from NCERT, as well as solve exemplar problem book also. Both are equally important. Just read any one chapter, either first PU or second PU. In one day, you should read one chapter of NCERT, no matter what, no excuses, nothing. If you have test, read NCERT of that test itself. But otherwise, read one chapter. If you repeat after totally around, if you combine both the years, let's say around like 150, 100 chapters, I think, how many will be there, including all PCMB of first PU as well as second PU. Let's say approximately 100 chapters are there. Read one by one, and no matter what, you have to read one chapter of NCERT. At least write down important ones, because you have another year. Just now CET got over, so in 1 year, you can do that at least like, let's say 3 to 4 times of reading each and every chapter. So that way you're continuously refreshed with the chapters of all the syllabus chapters. That was my next point. Yeah, and not just read exactly, just keep on highlighter or a pen or a pencil or whatever it is. Just highlight important points so that next time when you revise, you only read those. Other things, if you have time, you can. But during revision, you can just do that much itself. And yeah, don't forget to write about, formulas in a book, formulae in a book, right? Keep a formulae book. Now itself in my old videos of CET teaching also, and then many other guidance videos, tips to crack CET, everywhere I've told, keeping a formula book is very, very important. It is highly essential. So please do it if you haven't yet done it. At least in 11th, you should have done it. But since you have, if you have done it, well and good. But if you have not, then please do it at least now. So you have to keep a book and write all the important formulae in that book. The next one is, if you have any reference book, right? Any with a lot of questions, let's say like 100, 200, 300 per chapter. If you have those many questions in one single chapter, don't sit and solve each and every question, right? You start solving, then if you don't get, you spend time out on it, and then it just becomes a never-ending process and you won't get out of that chapter, you won't go to the next one. So what you do is solve either like odd number of problems or even number ones, like 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. I've told this many times also, I'm telling it again, so that you people don't waste time. So if it is let's say 100 questions are there in one chapter, you solve 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 till 99, that is 50 questions you have solved, and you though it is only half, but still you feel, I mean, that satisfactory feeling you get that you have finished the chapter somehow. While you are revising the chapter, solve the rest 50 or like next 25 problems or whatever it is. Try to finish it. If not possible, it's still fine. It's you should understand the concepts of that chapter. That is more important. So this was my next point. The other thing is, buy, at least now or like in another few months time, buy Arihant Handbook, right? It has, these are the books. I have them here. And I'm not being paid to promote it, but I just felt that these are really good books. So please solve these. I mean, not solve these, read these. Because they have important concepts as well as formulae for each chapter given very nicely in tabular form or like whatever it is. Like all the important concepts from NCERT they have picked up, as well as maybe from other resources. I have no idea, but they have created this book and then formulated this book really well. And it's there for each physics, chemistry as well as mathematics. Formulae, concepts, let's say in chemistry you have a chapter called as metallurgy. You haven't yet come up till there, but you have to remember the ore as well as its common name. That is like what is the formula, like magnetite, hematite, it is Fe2O3 or Fe3O4, whatever it is. You have to remember the common names, like many other common names are there. Calamite, dolo, many things are there. So those things you have to remember, and it's given very nicely in these books. So please buy these books, which will help you either just before the exam day or during the exam day also if you have time. So during that time, just for quick revision, this is very helpful. And the next one is, if you don't have a book to practice, let's say you don't have any reference book and you are in 12th now, that is just entered 12th. Obviously, because I'm making these videos for you people itself, what you do is let's say MTG or Bosco Publications or whatever it is, just go to a bookhouse, a bookshop, buy any set for PCMB if you are writing biology. Buy any book, if it is second hand also fine, if you want to buy new, it's still fine, that doesn't matter at all. What matters is whether you solve it sincerely or not. You have to solve such kind of books. So if you still don't have and you are just reading NCERT, buy one extra book so that you have you are exposed to different type of questions also. And they have a little bit higher level questions also, which helps you be at a greater level than the examination level, so that the examination feels easier for you. That is what I mean. So buy any book which has, you have to see the book carefully. Don't just buy blindly. What you do is, when you're buying, just check whether it has answer keys. Obviously, it'll have answer keys, but check if you have solutions also given in as much detail as possible. Well, I didn't know that. I had bought O.P. Tandon book for J Main and Advanced. That is GRB Publications. So I heard that the theory of the book is really good, and I read it. It was really, really good. And there are plenty of questions. It's not for CET though. It's for J Main and Advanced. But the only the drawback was that the questions don't have detailed solutions, especially for organic. You require the mechanism for some problems which you don't understand, but they only give answer keys but not the complete solution. So that is a problem. So buy the book which has both answer key as well as detailed solutions. You check them and then you buy it. And the last thing is, in your class, don't keep your doubts in the mind, right? Whatever it is, however silly it is, ask the doubt straight on the face to the teacher. Don't hesitate at all, because a person who asks his doubt, however dumb it may be, stays a fool for 5 minutes. Like during, if the teacher mocks or the friends laugh, whatever it is, he stays a fool for 5 minutes. But if you don't ask, thinking that you'll be ridiculed, you stay a fool for the whole year or like that. So just it doesn't matter whether teacher mocks you or like whatever it is. Ask your doubts, come openly and without any fear, because you are paying in that to be in that college or that coaching. You are paying means you have a full right to ask your doubts, and teachers have to clear it no matter what. And finally, I'd like to say that if at all you want any guidance, any queries, anything at all regarding CET preparation or JE Main preparation or whatever it is, please download the Bolo app from Play Store. A link is given in the description below. So please download that app and you can have a one-on-one session with me, and many other career experts are also there clearing your queries, and you can book sessions with me and then interact with me face-to-face on video call on scheduled times, which I have kept. So please download that app, and finally, thanks a lot for watching this video. Thank you.